Okay, I guess I will talk about the length extension attack since I have a slide for it. So the length extension attack, it doesn't necessarily break any of the things that we talked about earlier, but it is still something we want to avoid. So let's say that, again, I turn around, I come up with a secret value and I hash it, and I tell you the output hash. So I tell you what h of x is. And I also tell you the length of my input. So the word that I just hashed was 10 characters. So now you know the hash, and you know the length of the message, but I don't tell you what word I chose. What 10-letter word I chose will be a mystery to you forever. And the length extension attack says, if I give you this hash, you can actually continue running the hash algorithm from wherever I left off to compute the hash of my message concatenated with some other message. So even though you don't know what x is, you can compute the hash of whatever my secret word was plus your favorite word, and you can compute that hash. Well, that's pretty bad. It doesn't break one-wayness or collision resistance because you couldn't figure out the x that I used or something that hashes to h of x. You also didn't find a collision, but you were able to keep running my hash algorithm based on my output to get the hash of my secret plus some other secret. So this is a little bit dangerous, depending on your threat model. If you check out the homework assignment, there is a demo of what this looks like. And depending on your threat model, maybe this is something you don't want. So SHA-2 is vulnerable to this. SHA-3 patched this issue. But that's what a length extension attack is. I think trying it out will be helpful to understanding what it does. But just remember that it's like I'm giving you the output, and you somehow continue running the hash algorithm from where I left off to get the hash of my secret plus your secret, even though you had no idea what my secret word was.